that so-called Mexicans, many of them Texans for seven generations, are covered with a Caucasian cloak, is when it serves the ends of those who would shamelessly deny this large segment of the Texas population their fundamental rights. Texas's high court was not persuaded. The appeal was denied. The next step for the Hernandez lawyers, and a very risky one, was to turn to the United States Supreme Court.
It was an unusual ambition to take a case beyond Texas and to take it to the U.S. Supreme Court. Moreover, no Mexican Americans had ever tried a case in the U.S. Supreme Court. They had no reason to believe that they would win.
The lawyers in Hernandez gambled when they decided to take this case to the Supreme Court. They knew on the upside that they could win national recognition for the equality of Mexican Americans. But they knew on the downside that if they lost, they would establish at a national level the proposition that Mexican Americans could be treated as second-class citizens. And not just that. They knew that this was probably their one shot in a generation.
An appeal to the Supreme Court of the United States is a costly matter. You have to pay a filing fee. You have to pay for the printing of the briefs. You have to pay to travel to Washington, D.C. to argue the case.
They didn't even have money to get up there, much less to really fight the case.